I think you've just got to get involved in it. If you have any sort of a inkling that you'd like to be in a soil carbon project, then it's about putting your toe in the water and getting involved in it. Otherwise, you just don't understand it. We're on Moora Plains at Gagenge. It's about 3,500 hectares, and we mainly run trade cattle mobs on here. So we received ACCUs last year, and that's going to play a large part in how we move the business forward into the next generation. Gives us a chance to bring sons home, build some more infrastructure for them to be able to move home. So yeah, it's pretty exciting for us. We got interested in carbon farming because it was a way of economically measuring the soil carbon, so putting a baseline on it so that we had a starting point. We already had a degree of intensivity in what we were doing, but we split some paddocks, we added another 7 paddocks, and was mostly around boosting water flow so we could combine mobs. We run a fairly intensive rotational grazing system. We used to have 4 or 5 mobs, whereas now we're largely running one. Mostly it's around keeping that density as high as we can for as long as we can. We're at the point with our grazing manager that we were getting reasonably comfortable with it. It was having those multiple mobs, it was pretty easy to manage. And the soil carbon project really gave us that kick along to increase density, and it's pretty confronting. I mean, at times we're sort of running 1,600 head in one mob, and that can be a little bit confronting when we consider the infrastructure, yards, drafting, that sort of infrastructure that we need to use. So honestly, we probably wouldn't have made that shift without the soil carbon project.
Carbon project process works by taking an already operating farm and applying a new activity to that land that's known to sequester carbon. Increasing carbon in the soil is important because soil is the biggest carbon sink that we manage. It allows us to improve a lot of environmental conditions, so you've got things like improving the water holding capacity of the soil, improving the ability for water to penetrate when it does rain. You've also got the impact on the ecosystem and the atmosphere, so any carbon that is added into the soil or vegetation has been removed from the atmosphere to allow that to happen.
We use Moora grazing to capture and monitor the grazing that we do. So that gives us things like paddock yields, days rest, average amount of grazes per year. That's all things that I used to do manually, but now we can do it a lot quicker using an electronic method. The challenges we had to overcome were largely around water flow. With the mob split the way they used to be split, the water flow could comfortably handle the numbers that we were running. So we had to boost flow in some systems, reroute pipelines to existing troughs to get better flow. We're enjoying seeing how the trees are coming back and how the cattle work their way through the trees. Pasture dieback put a little bit of a kink in the system in that we lost a lot of that grass cover under the trees, but we're seeing that coming back, especially with that increase in density. They're definitely a lot more contented under trees, I think. We got some camels quite a while ago now, and thinking that they may do a job on briglow and black wattle regrowth. And as a bit of a byproduct of that, love the way they interact with the cattle, especially young cattle, calves. They keep them a lot calmer, and they seem to have had an effect on dingo control, just the way the wild dogs interact with the cattle. I guess growing up here, knowing what it used to be to where it was when we moved back home, it was slowly trending in the wrong direction. Dad was always very conservative in his stocking, but was still set stocked. So you can just see those bare patches growing. Cattle management seemed to make it difficult to keep trees, and that's probably been the difference. The fact that we're moving cattle regularly and they're in small paddocks, we can manage them through the trees. So yeah, we're comfortable to let trees grow. Oh yeah, I couldn't manage any other way now.